never met a girl who makes me feel the way that you do. You're alright. Whatever I ask, who makes my dream real? I see the beauty. You're outside. So be far. Move on. Look out, baby, because here I come. All right. Good morning, Hamilton Middle School. That was The Temptations. Great request from Miss Moreland. We were all dancing, just having a good time. So happy Thursday, everyone. Remember, it is May 14th. It is Thursday, so you are signing into your purple classes. All right, so our quote of the day is to keep going. Each step might get harder, but don't stop. The view is beautiful at the top. Remember, our profile, learner profile of the week is also inquiry. So being inquisitive, being an inquirer, that helps you get to the top. Ask questions. That's how you find out answers, and that's how you get further. Today we are celebrating that it is Thursday. Yay for Thursday. We're going to talk a little bit about next year. We have some bus updates, some registration updates. We're also reminding you that Multicultural Celebration is this Friday at 2. We are so excited to have a watch party. We hope that to see you all there. Love it. And don't forget to buy a yearbook. We'll talk a little bit more about that in a little bit. Student closeout is what we're going to talk about next. And so how we kind of wrap up this year with your belongings. And that we have two very special guests this week. We have Ms. Brushway with us and Ms. Moreland. So student closeout. Unfortunately, you won't be able to come out of the school because you were already out of the school and we do miss you so much. But as far as closeout goes, we do want to make it an easy and safe and healthy process for you. And so we want to make it very clear that if you are a student who is staying in a DPS school next year, you only need to return to Hamilton any musical instrument you might have and any textbook or library book you might have. And so Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday next week, we will be at Hamilton in the Circle Drive from 9 a.m. to 12 p.m. where you can pop your trunk, your parents can pop their trunk. We will go get whatever is in your trunk out, your books or your instruments or your books and your instruments, and we will take care of them from there. So you don't even have to get out of your car. In fact, you can't get out of your car. If you do come walking, that's fine. Please try to bring a mask with you. We really want to make sure that we have masks, and then you can just drop it off with one of us and we will maintain our 6 feet of social distancing. So thank you everyone for following those instructions. It's really important for the safety of those of us who are collecting your instruments and your books. Now, if you are leaving DPS, it is very important that we do get all technology back if you are leaving DPS. We still also need your musical instruments and your textbooks if you are leaving DPS. We won't collect those until May 29th because we want you to have access to all of your classes until the very last day. So if you are leaving DPS, we do want your technology, your instruments, and your textbooks, but we won't ask for those back until May 29th so that you can continue with your online learning. Lockers. We've been having a lot of people ask about lockers due to our locker system, which we share lockers. So there are lots of belongings to a lot of different people in lockers. And the safety procedures that we would need to have to clean out lockers and to organize your belongings, we've decided we're going to wait for locker cleanout until students are once again allowed back into the building so that we can make sure that the right belongings go to the right students. Technology, again, we are not collecting technology unless you are leaving Denver Public Schools. If you are leaving Denver Public Schools, we do need your technology. If you're not, don't worry about it. Eighth graders, you're going to take your technology to ninth grade with you, and our sixth graders, incoming sixth graders, should arrive with technology. We now are going to pass it over to Ms. Moreland. Good morning, Ms. Moreland. We are so happy to have you.
Good morning, ladies. Good morning, Huskies. I miss you so much. I want to make sure that you have this information. Please, scholars, check your email and Google Calendar daily for invites. Matter of fact, you might want to check it twice a day, once about mid-morning and then once about mid-afternoon. Please join your teachers' live office hours. That is where you are going to get assistance for with any questions you may have, any difficulties that you may have about your assignments, as well as some general conversation. But just remember, your assignments come first, then general conversation. Be in the first wave to fill out your transportation form to opt in or opt out of riding the bus next. Be done by May 28th. The forms and applications will not be open until July 20th. You don't want to miss out of possibly getting a seat on the bus early. And that, remember, you will still have to qualify. It goes the same for exceptions. If for some reason there is an exception and you need to ride the bus, like for daycare, even though, you know, you're old enough to be at home by yourselves, your parents may want you to go someplace else that will cause you to have to ride a bus. Though all those forms need to be filled out by May 28th. If you have any questions, make sure that you email transportation@dpsk12.org. And finally, it is time for your parents or guardian to update your student information in IC campus, in Infinite Campus, excuse me. They need to go to schoolchoice.dpsk12.org in order to update that information. This also needs to be done by May 28th to help you with your fall registration, to speed up fall registration. It also helps us know whether or not you are coming back. I know things will change over the summer, so you can actually go in by, make sure you go in by May 28th. During the course of the summer, if your information changes, please contact the school of choice to find out what the process is for correcting your information. Thank you, Husky. Reminder, we've got about 2 days left to order your yearbook. Oh, and look, I see Dr. Al-Islam, I see Nico and a bunch of our students up there in the basketball. And down here, I see the wonderful Funapalooza that we have. All kinds of important and exciting events are going to be in that yearbook, along with the pictures of your friends. So please go to yearbookordercenter.com and order your yearbook. Husky. This week's kindness challenge for Huskies. Husky. Cards for seniors. On your right, you have a list of nursing homes and senior facilities that are accepting cards because the people in those facilities are shut in. They can't get out. People can't come in to see them because of the coronavirus. Lighten their lives, brighten their day by please writing a card. And you can simply say, "Hi, my name is, I'm writing this because I know you cannot get out and I wanted to brighten your day. I'll be happy. Stay in contact with your family. I'm glad you're healthy." Things along those lines, guys, and brighten their day. Give them something funny that you've done, a silly joke you've heard, or something funny that has gone on in your family, or even helpful that has gone on with your family. They'd love to hear from you. Okay? So, and you can go back to Morning Message and get this information as to where to mail it to. You can even email it. You don't have to put a stamp on it and put it in the Postal Service. All right, and email it to the people that are underlined there. Thank you so much. And think about your grandparents, your great aunts, your great grandparents that may be in a facility and reach out. Husky. Learner profile inquirer. This quote is, we have to thank Ms. Brushway for it. We learn more by looking for answers and not finding it than we do from learning the answer itself. And in case you don't know what an inquirer is, I know a lot of you do, that is a person who asks questions. Never be afraid to ask a question. The only dumb question is the one that you have that you do not ask. So please keep that in mind. And Husky.
guys, Brushway here. Just a few reminders about ICAP. So sixth and eighth graders, listen up. You need to complete your fourth quarter ICAP lesson. So it is in your sixth grade course in Schoology. So if you're a sixth grader, there's a course in Schoology where you can go in and complete this. Eighth grade, you go through your history class. So go to your social studies class in Schoology and they'll have information where you can complete it. Seventh grade, you guys already finished this before remote learning started. So seventh graders, you are good to go. Husky. All right, guys, today's wellness activity. So brainstorming with others. So let's read through some of this. The only way to have a friend is to be one. A friend is someone who makes it easy to believe in yourself. A good friend is like a four-leaf clover, hard to find and lucky to have. The language of friendship is not words, but meanings. So leaning on others to brainstorm solutions to challenges anyone can relate to can bring a fresh and new perspective on working through challenges. So think about how you are with your friends. Has a friend ever come to you with a challenge they were facing and come to you for advice or come to you thinking, I just don't know how to feel about this? I challenge you to find a friend or even yourself, reach out to a friend and brainstorm together. Find a challenge, ask a friend about a challenge, and brainstorm together to bring yourselves closer together and have fresh and new perspectives. Husky. All right, guys, so how today will look. Again, this is your suggested schedule. So this is something that can help you if you're like, I'm not good at organizing my time. That's okay, we've done it for you. So from 9 to 10, eat a nice breakfast, something yummy, try to be healthy, watch the morning meeting, go back through the PowerPoint slides for morning meeting if you need more information, especially I know Dean Moreland gave a lot of information that you need to share with your parents, go get that. And then set up your learning space. Get yourself somewhere comfortable, somewhere with good light, somewhere. I always have a sleeping kitten in my lap. That's my comfortable working space. All right, from 10 to 11:30, you're gonna check in with your purple day teachers. That means take attendance, guys. Fill out those attendance forms for your purple classes, all of them. Then you're gonna complete 1 to 2 assignments and go to live office hours. From 11:30 to 12:30, take lunch, get away from the computer, do the wellness activity, do a physical activity, do something with your family or friends, lunch, anything you need. 12:30 to 1:30, more self-care. Take care of yourself, read, meditate, take a nap, watch your favorite TV show, write in your journal, anything that gets you taking care of yourself and your own needs. From 1:30 to 2, read. Find something fun to read. If you don't know, email a teacher or a friend. Be like, hey, what should I read? Okay, all sorts of things you can read. From 2 to 3, complete another assignment. Want to get that work done by Friday. Work on the kindness activity. Write those letters or those cards. Or you can work on the wellness activity for this week. Take that challenge. Brainstorm with a friend. And then from 3 to 4, check your email. Like Ms. Moreland said, check your email, check your Google Calendar, check for invites, check back in with a teacher to make sure you've turned in at least 2 assignments, go to more office hours, whatever you need to finish up your day in a positive way that makes you feel like you accomplished something. Husky.
Thank you, Ms. Brushway. Thank you, Ms. Moreland. This was a really fun morning meeting. I'm so glad both of you were here with me. So remember, students tune in every morning at 9 a.m. to our morning announcements. Buy a yearbook if you want one. This is a year you will want to remember. So buy a yearbook if you want one. Eighth graders, make sure to mark your calendar. Know that the virtual continuation, May 28th at 6 p.m. We're so excited to see you all there. And check all of your classes for your progress reports or progress updates if you haven't already. It's really good for you to know your own standing. Again, your inquiry, right? You want to know where you are and how you can improve. And mark your calendar for this Friday, 2 p.m. Multicultural Celebration Watch Party. We're once again so excited to see you all there. And we're going to end as we always do, which is let's remember who we are. Ms. Moreland, you were on mute. Let's try that again. Oh, that's okay. We're going to try it one more time. Let's remember who we are.
We are the community of Hamilton Middle School.
Let's make it a great day.
Go Huskies. Bye, everybody.
Bye, guys. Bye.